Sometimes in our program, we want to repeat same action multiple times. For example, I want to console log hello world 5 times. The hard way to do that would be to write code again and again. This code works, but the idea of programming is to make things easy, not hard. So in JavaScript, to repeat a task, we can use loops. And there are multiple loops in JavaScript for repeating the task multiple times, such as for loop and while loop. We'll start with for loop. So for loop takes three statements. The first statement is used for initialization. We initialize the value by defining a variable and initializing the value to zero. The second statement is condition. It helps the loop in deciding when to stop the loop. So whenever this condition returns false, it will stop the loop. So I'm saying I less than 5. So whenever I is less than 5, keep going, otherwise stop. The third statement explains what to do after every iteration. So I want after every iteration, the value of I should go up by 1. And here we can go ahead and log the message that we want to log. In output, we can see hello world printed 5 times. Let's go ahead and see how the value of I is changing after every iteration. I'll go ahead and log the value of I. If we refresh, we can see the value of I started with 0. That is the job of first statement. After 0, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the job of third statement is for incrementing the value after every iteration. So to understand it better, let's go through this diagram. So the first statement helps you in starting the loop. Second statement is about stopping the loop, when to stop. Third statement, what to do after each iteration. So now what if we want to print from 0 to 10? So now what will happen if I change the value from 5 to 10? And we can see the output will be 0 to 9. And the reason, because only when the value of I is 10, this condition becomes false and loop breaks. Now what if we want to print all the odd number from 1 to 10? So for that, we'll use condition because we have to make decisions. Condition will be I modulus 2. Modulus operator returns the remainder and will check if it is not equal to 0. It means the number is odd. And we can see the output 1, 3, 5, 7. Similarly, if we remove the not operator, it will give us all the even numbers. Right now the output is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So I want the output be in descending order. So for that, I want the value to start with 9. And it can keep going if the value of I is greater than 0. And every time it is coming, I just want to decrease the value by 1. So if we do that, the output will come like 8, 6, 4, 2. If you want to include 0 also, you can just go ahead and say greater than or equal to. And we'll see the output 86420. So by changing the start and when to stop, we can control the flow of loop. So this is how we can implement for loop. Let's move on to the next loop, that is while. While loop takes a condition, and when the condition is true, it executes the body. When the condition is false, the loop breaks. We'll go ahead and implement the same example in while loop. While needs a condition, so condition here is I less than 10. And we'll copy the body. So if we do this and run the code, we'll see it will throw an error, I is not defined, because we haven't defined the variable I. In for loop, the first thing we do is to define the variable. So just to fix this, let's go ahead and say I is equal to 0. If you do this and execute the code will go in infinite loop, a loop that has no ending. What it means is the value of I is 0. What you're doing, you're checking I is less than 10. So 0 is less than 10 and it is true. It will execute this block. It will go ahead and check again. Because the value of I is never changing, the loop will never stop. And that is called infinite loop. So this is one of the common mistakes while writing while loop, is that we forget to increment the value. And the only way to increment the value of I in while loop is to increment it in the body. So for example, I can just go ahead and say I is equal to I plus 1. So now what will happen, the value of I is 0, this is true, it will get executed because the value of I is incrementing. There will be a time that this will be false and loop will break. So now if we execute this code, we'll see exact same output that we saw in for loop. So for and while have different requirements. So while choosing between for loop and while loop, you should think about some of the criteria. Like you should be using while loop when you just all you have is a condition, and based on that you have to execute some piece of code. Something like, say, if you're reading a file, you don't know the number of lines in that file. So in those cases, we can use while. But in most of the cases, when we have our initial value, our final value, and what to do after each iteration, go for for loop. These are the multiple ways of implementing loops in JavaScript. We can use for loop or we can use while loop.